Welcome to all. In this video we will see how to assign the object reference variables. Okay, so here you can see the example. Box is a class where we have created one variable called b1. Okay, using new operator we are going to create the object. When we can create the object, by default the constructors will be called and you are going to, as you know, allocate memory for the variables which are available inside the class. In this particular example, box is a class, so whatever the variables we have inside the box, so all the variables will be given with the memory location, isn't it? We are going to allocate the memory for all the variables. So for example, if you have one class and if you have three, you know, objects for the same class, then three copies of memory will be allocated for all the variables which is available in that particular class. So here you can see in the first line, so we are creating one variable object called b1. Okay, so in the second line you can see, so along with the class name, what you are going to do, you are going to create one more object with the name b2, and we are assigning the reference of b1. So automatically what happens, automatically b1 and b2 will be pointing to the same variable location. So whatever the variable we have, so b1 and b2, both objects will be referring to same thing. How? Because of we are assigning the reference to the new object which is being created. So you can see over there, so you might think that b2 is being assigned a reference to a copy of the object referred to by b1. Okay, that is, you might think that b1 and b2 refer to the separate and distinct objects. However, this would be wrong. Instead, after this fragment executes, b1 and b2 will both refer to the same object. You can see the thing on that image. Okay, so you can concentrate on the image here. So b1 is one object, b2 is another object. So both the objects are created for the class b box, and both the objects are referring to same variable location, that is nothing but width, height and depth. These are the three variables which are available inside the class box, and with the data type double. So usually what happens, if you are going to create separate, you know, objects, each and every object will be having its own set of width, height and depth. But when you assign the reference of a object to another object, so this happens. So both the objects will be referring to same variable locations of class. Okay, so although b1 and b2 both refer to the same object, they are not linked in any other way. So for example, the subsequent assignment to b1 will simply unhook b1 from the original object without affecting the object or affecting b2. So you can see the example over here. So box b1 equal to new box and box b2 equal to b1 up to, so b1 equal to null. So whatever the code it goes between b2 and b1. So b1 here, b1 has set to null, but b2 still points to the original object. That also possible. So it is just for the reference kind of work, not for the entire copying of entire thing. Okay, it is just a reference so that this b2 object also can refer to a particular memory location which is being referred by b1. So ultimately you are setting the reference thing. So this is the one of the thing which you have to understand for object reference variable. The next thing is introducing methods. Okay, so methods, see, I already said in the rest of the programming language what happens, we usually say functions, but when it comes for Java, when it comes for C#, instead of using the term functions, we go for methods. Both are same, don't get confused. Again and again I would like to say the same thing. Okay, so there you can see the general form of a method, that is nothing but a type name followed by parameter list, whatever the parameter, any number of parameters can this methods can take, and inside that body of the method, whatever the code you want to write, you can write it inside the braces. Okay, so next, here the type specifies the type of the data returned by the method. So just a moment, there is a, you know, disturbance. I will just pause once. Okay, pardon me for that disturbance. So yeah, here the type specifies the type of data returned by the method. This can be any valid type. Okay, you can go for any valid type, it may be int, char, float, double, anything. Okay, so it is just type, return type. What is the value which will be returned by that method? That is the meaning. Okay, if you are going for void, that means that method will not return anything to the calling you know, function or calling method or calling instruction. Okay, so if the method does not return a value, the yeah, that must be void. So the same thing I said. Okay, next you can see the example over here, adding a method to the box class. So how can we add a method to that previous box class? So for all the example, we are taking one class. So not just because it is hectic, but it is very easy to explain also. So but when you start coding, it is not mandatory that you have to go for the same class box. You can take your own name, you can take anyone's name, you can create any class with any name. That is possible. Okay, but make sure that don't use any predefined keywords or, you know, the keywords which are already available in the programming. Okay, like main or float. Class float not possible, class main is not possible. But if you go for capital M, that's okay. Small M, it is one of the name for the method, isn't it? You cannot make it as a class. That is the meaning. Okay, so you can go for that example. So you have class box. Inside the class you have three variables, width, height and depth of type double. Okay, now you have one method here. See, void volume, it is a method, isn't it, which is defined inside the class box. It is not declaration, it is a definition of a method. So declaration means you are just declaring what kind of things you want to do or how exactly a method looks like. But defining means you have to write, after writing the return type, method name, inside the braces you have to write the entire body of the method, or you want to write the code which is available for that method. In this case you have a method called volume. Okay, inside the volume method, what you have two print statements. One is for volume is, and next line you are going for print ln. So don't get confused, print also prints the same output, but when you go for print ln, after printing some output, new line will be given, or next line will be, the cursor will be blinking in the next line. Okay, that dash, okay, that will be blinking in the next line. So what happens here, system.out.println, inside the braces you have width into height into depth. That means this volume method will calculate the volume of the data or number or value you provided to height, width and depth. That is a meaning. Now how to access this, we will see in the next slide. So here, so you have one class called box demo 3. Okay, inside this class you have main method. Okay, so inside the main method, what you are going to do, you are going to create two objects. So box, my box one is one object and my box two is another object. How to create the objects? Class name followed by variable of that object, object name equal to new operator, then again box class. Okay, you have to follow that syntax to create the object in Java. So in this program you have created two objects, my box one and as well as my box two. Okay, now how to access width, height and depth? Using my box one or using first object, you are going to do you have to use the dot operator. So here, see, my box one dot width equal to 10. That means the object my box one, which is referred to a particular variable, that is nothing but width, will be assigned with the value 10. That is the meaning. So whatever the value you are going to assign to width of object 1 with the name mybox1 will be given the value 10. So I already said, so whenever you create the object, separate set of memory will be allocated for the variables. So here you have two objects. So you are not going for reference. You are not assigning the reference of one object to another object. You are creating separate objects for box class. So that is my box one and my box two. That means there will be one set of width, height and depth for my box one, and there is a separate set of width, height and depth will for my box two. So separate memory location will be there. So my box one width equal to 10. So you are assigning 10 to width of first object. 20 will be assigned to height of first object. 15 will be assigned to depth of first object. And for second object, how to do? My box 2 dot width, my box 2 dot height, my box 2 dot depth. So you are assigning value 3 to width of second object, 6 to height of second object, 9 to depth of second object. Now once you are done with these, so what happens? Now height, width will be having two values, 10 and 3. 10 for first object, 3 for second object. Now height will be having two values, 20 for first object, 6 for second object. And depth will be having again three values, 15 for first object and 9 for second object. Now what happens? Now you are going to call the volume method. That volume method is residing inside the class box, isn't it? you have defined a separate method called volume inside class box. Now how to call? Now you are calling using first object, my box one dot volume. Now what happens whenever you call a particular method using an object, the whatever the value you assigned for the variables using that object, that will be carried automatically to the method. Okay, so using mybox1.volume, you have passed here. So by default, the volume, the values of 10, 20 and 15, because mybox1 will be holding these three values, isn't it? Because mybox1 will be referring to the variables width, height and depth, which has the value 10, 20 and 15. Implicitly, these three values will be carried to volume method. So once it is carried, what happens here? You can see you are going to multiply width, height and depth. So this 10 into 20 into 15 will be there. So you are going to multiply these three values. Okay, now in the next line, what happens next? You are going to do, you are using second object to call volume method. Now what are the values for second object? So it is 3, 6 and 9. So width, height and depth value referred by object 2 will be having the values 3, 6 and 9. So 3, 6 and 9 will be implicitly carried to volume method. Now what happens? Again, you are going to call the volume method. And now in this example, in this time, width will be 3, 6 and 9. Height will be 6 and depth will be 9. So whatever the value you are going to get, the same thing will be printed. How it will be printed? Because you have the statement system.out.println. Inside that you are passing width into height into depth. So you just in right now you have called this volume method using second object. So this second object will be holding the value 3, 6 and 9, isn't it? So the same value will be passed and you are going to get the output. So for my box one, you are going to get the value as 3000. Why? 10 into 20 into 15. And for this you are going to get how much? Just multiply, I don't know, 3 into 6 into 9, whatever the value. If you are very good at maths, you get the answer. I'm not that much good at maths. So you can go for a calculator or you can just calculate the value of this. So ultimately, what is the meaning? Ultimately, you are going to get two values. First, my box 1 will have separate value and my box 2 will have separate value. Okay, so that means, that directly means how many number of objects you create for a particular class, that many number of copies of memory, you know, will be allocated for all the variables which are residing inside the class. That is the meaning. So this is just how you can deal with the method. Now you have one more concept called returning a value. So in the previous explanation, I said there is a return type. So what are the values which you are going to return to a particular calling method or calling instruction, isn't it? So if you are not returning anything, you usually go for void. So void main, you go for void main means you are not returning any value to value from main function. Sometimes in some examples you would have seen int main. So even though you don't send any value to the calling function, you just in the last line you go for return 0. Have you ever seen? So if you are going for int main, by default you are sending 0 to the calling thing, calling function. Okay, so why? Because the return type is int. You must return something, otherwise you will get the error. That is the reason why return type, whatever the return type you write for a particular function in this in Java method, I'm using the word method. So whatever the return type you go for a particular method, that value has to be returned to the calling method. Okay, so here, see, you can take the example, the same example, class box, again three variables, height, width and depth. Next you have double volume. So in the previous example you had void volume, that means volume did not return any value, volume method did not return any value to the calling method. Which is the calling method in the previous example? That is mybox1.volume. That is the calling method, isn't it? From main method you try to call volume method, which is residing in class box. But in this example, what you are going to do? You are using the return type as double. That means, that directly means volume method will return a particular value which is of type double. ಅರ್ಥ ಏನಂತೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ಜಾವದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಮೆಥಡ್ ಅಂತ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ಗೆ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವಂತಹ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಒಂದು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂವನ್ನು ಕಾಲಿಂಗ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಥವಾ ಮೈನ್ ಮೆಥಡಿಂದ ನೀವು ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರಲ್ವ, ಸೊ ಮೈ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಡಾಟ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಅಂತ ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರಲ್ವ, ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಎಂತ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಇದು ವಿಡ್ತ್ ಇಂಟು ಹೈಟ್ ಇಂಟು ಡೆಪ್ತ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅದು ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಆದದ್ದು ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಂದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮೈನ್ ಮೆಥಡಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಡಬಲ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಡೆಮೋ 4. ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಡೆಮೋ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೈನ್ ಮೆಥಡ್. ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಮೈನ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು ವೇರಿಯೇಬಲ್, ಸಾರಿ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಮೈ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ 1 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೈ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ 2. ಸೊ ಸಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಪೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಯುನೋ ವೇರಿಯೇಬಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್. ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್. ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಗೋಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಚ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಮೆಥಡ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್. ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೇಮ್. ಸಾರಿ, ಮೈ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ 1 ಡಾಟ್ ವಿಡ್ತ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 10, ಮೈ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ 1 ಡಾಟ್ ಹೈಟ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 20, ಮೈ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ 1 ಡಾಟ್ ಡೆಪ್ತ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 15. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಮೈ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ 1 ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ 10, 20 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 15, ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಮೈ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ 2 ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ 3, 6 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 9. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಸಿ, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಸಪ್ರೇ ಲಿಟ್ಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್. ವಿ ಓ ಎಲ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಮೈ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ 1 ಡಾಟ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್. ವೈ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ this instruction is being executed, so what happens, my box 1 dot volume means you are directly calling the volume method which is available inside the class. Now whenever the control goes to this you know this volume method, what happens after calculating width into height into depth, the value, the result, the answer will be returned to the calling method. Which is the calling method? See, this is the calling method, my box 1 dot volume. Whenever it is returned, that value has to be caught somewhere, isn't it? Aa banda value anna elladru neevu store maadbeku, direct aagi neevu haage barilikke agudilla. So aa store maadbekadre, to store that you require one more variable, that is nothing but VOL, volume. So volume is of type what? Double. Sorry, volume is of type double. So you have to remember, see here, see, double space volume. So you declared one variable called VOL of type double. Why double? ಯಾಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಯಾವ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೇಟಾವನ್ನು ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಮೇನ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಸಾರಿ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಮೆಥಡಿಂದ, ಆ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಯಾವ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ ಅದೇ ಟೈಪಿಗಾಗುವಂತಹ ವೇರಿಯೇಬಲನ್ನು ನೀವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿರ್ತದೆ. You cannot go for int or float or any other. Say, can you receive a integer value in a character variable? It is not possible, isn't it? Isn't it? String, okay, that string is a separate part of story. Okay, if you go for, because in some cases, all the numbers, all the data is considered as a string. That is a separate part of stories there. But usually, you cannot do that. Can you hold, float value in an integer variable? Not possible. You don't get that dot operator, that that point, decimal point, you won't get. So there are some criteria, there are some steps which you have to follow as a programmer. Okay, so that is the reason why I said. So here, that is the thing why VOL equal to my box 1 dot volume. So that means this VOL volume, this variable will hold the value which is returned by volume method of that class box. Okay, so in the same case, my box 2 will send the, again you will get the separate value. So that is nothing but 3000 and one more, that 3 into 6 into 9, you calculate. So that is 18 into 9. Okay, so that is how this works. Okay, you have to, if you have the system, try to execute this. If you are going for online compiler, that also well and good. Try to execute these programs so that you don't get confused when you write a program. So this is how return a value. So ultimately you are returning a value from a particular method, and the same value will be caught here. So you are not writing, learning any rocket science. You have seen these kind of things in C also, in C++ also. You have seen function returning a value to a function, returning a parameter to a particular function, or calling a particular function, a call by reference, call by value. I hope you remember all those things. The same thing is applied in Java also. You don't have anything special here, but ultimately you are calling a particular method using object. That is a difference. But in C you don't have the concept of object, but in C++ again you tried to call a particular function using object itself. There also you used object followed by the dot operator, then function name in C++. In Java, the same concept, ditto copy, you don't have anything special here. Again, object name, dot operator and method name. That's it. okay, the same concept. Next, you have something called constructors. Okay, I'm pretty sure that you know the concept of constructors. In C++, you used this. So what I was trying to say, whenever you create an object, by default, one constructor will be invoked, or that is nothing but default constructor. Usually, if you want to assign some values to the variables which are residing inside the class, you can pass the values using constructors. Okay, whenever you create an object, by default, a constructor will be invoked or called. Fine. So it can be tedious to initiate all the variables in a class each time an instance is created. Even when you add convenience function like a set dimension, that is one example. So that example will be, you can see that example in the next video. Okay, next slide, it is next slide. The example for constructor is given in the next video. Okay, set dimension. It would be simpler and more concise to have all the setup done at the time the object is first created. Because the requirement for initialization is so common, Java allows objects to initialize themselves when they are created. This automatic initialization is performed through through the use of constructor. So all the initialization work can be done using constructor. Okay, so if you want to print something, see, instead of using some, you know, the printf statement in the main method, you can just create, or you can add some, you know, a printf statement inside the constructor also. You have to just create an object. When you create object, default constructor will be called. That constructor will print whatever the things you want to do. And you have to remember the constructor name will be same as the class name, and constructor will not have the return type. Constructor ಗೆ ಯಾವುದು ಸಹ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ವಾಯ್ಡ್, ಇಂಟ್, ಮೇನ್. ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪಾಸಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟರ್ ನೇಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ನೇಮ್. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಎನಿ ಟಾಸ್ಕ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆನ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಮೈನ್ ಮೆಥಡ್, ಆಟೋಮೆಟಿಕಲಿ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಸಮ್ ಟಾಸ್ಕ್ ವಿದೌಟ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ಕೋಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೈನ್ ಮೆಥಡ್. ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ದ ಕೋಡ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದಿ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟರ್. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟರ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪುಟ್ ದ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟರ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. That is the thing. Okay, so there are some points here. The constructor initializes an object immediately upon creation. It has the same name as the class name, which resides inside, you know, and is syntactically similar to the method, so the same thing they have, they have gone for some standard statements. Okay, once defined, the constructor is automatically called immediately after the object is created, before the new operator completes. So you have to remember this point. So constructor is automatically called, so whenever you are using, whenever you are just, you know, object you are trying to create, before the new operator or initialization of something, you know, allocation of something or initialization, or, you know, creating some memory space, before all those, you know, work, this constructor will be invoked. Okay, so constructor look like a, you know, little strange, because they don't have return type. That is the reason why it looks like a little bit strange, but the name will be same as the class name. Okay, even it won't have void also. Fine. So this is because the implicit return type of the class constructor is the class type itself. You have to remember the last line. So if someone asks why it won't have the return type, without return type, how exactly it works? So that means, so you will be having the class type itself, or the constructor is of type class itself. So if you are going for the class name box, then you can go for box and braces, or, you know, parenthesis, not braces, parenthesis. And if someone asks why this particular thing doesn't have the, you know, return type, either you can say it is a constructor, or you can update the constructor like box space box and parenthesis. That also possible, because the constructor will have the same type of type like the class type, because ultimately class is a particular type, isn't it? A user defined data type. Class is a user defined data type. It acts like that. Okay, so these are the some of the information I just wanted to give. The example program for this constructor is given in the next video. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can approach me. Yes, thanks for watching.